Let's talk about Tauri Plugin. I introduced commands and events in previous videos. If you're not familiar with the concepts, I recommend you watch them first before learning plugins. In this video, I will introduce how plugins work, how to use a plugin, how to write a plugin, and how to publish a plugin. Tauri Plugin is actually very simple, just like a regular library, but designed for Tauri apps to save developers from reinventing the wheel. Suppose I wrote app 1, where I implemented a read clipboard command to read clipboard information. Later, I wrote app 2, and requires implementing exactly the same functionality. For this kind of duplicate code, it makes sense to extract the logic into a separate library. If I open source it, other developers will be able to use it in their apps. The awesome Tauri repo is a good source to find plugins as well as other Tauri apps. In fact, I believe currently the best way to learn Tauri is to read the source code of products listed here. This is a source of high-quality sample code. Documentation is always limited, so reading other people's code becomes the best way to learn. For myself, the best way to learn a new technology like Tauri is to build a project. If you build a Tauri app, you could also send a pull request to this repo and share your app with the community. Since we are talking about plugins, let's look at the plugin section. I wrote 3 of them. I'm using them in a Tauri app I'm still working on, and I thought these are very common functionalities, and it would be helpful for other people if I extract the logic into plugins so other developers don't have to reinvent the wheels. A Tauri app has 2 parts, Tauri core and frontend. They communicate with each other with commands and events. So if we need to extract the logic into a plugin library, we usually need to do it for both frontend and Tauri core. Here, let's assume we are using a JavaScript framework to build the frontend. The JavaScript code will be packaged into an API npm package. The Rust code will be packaged into a Rust crate. They're just like any regular JavaScript or Rust libraries, so you can publish them to the registry. I will show you how to do that. After publishing the packages, other developers will be able to install the plugin using a cargo and npm. Before writing a plugin, let's look at how to use a plugin. We first install the packages. In the main function of main.rs, include the plugin in the builder, and that's it. In JavaScript, simply import the functions and call them like regular functions. For example, when readText function is called, it invokes the readText command in the clipboard plugin. Note that to invoke a command from a plugin, the name should be prefixed with plugin colon, the plugin's name, and a bar to distinguish from a regular command. That's pretty simple, right? Let's build a plugin. Tauri's CLI tool can generate a ready-to-go plugin boilerplate, which is very convenient. In the documentation, you are told to use an npm script to build the plugin by running npm run Tauri. But this requires you to be in an existing Tauri project with the CLI package. This is not convenient if I just want to start a plugin as a standalone project. So I prefer to call Tauri app CLI directly using npx. Here let's call the plugin clipboard. For simplicity, let's assume it has one command called readText. The generated boilerplate is a regular Rust library with a lib.rs file and an example project which you can use to test your plugin during developments. It's also helpful when other developers want to learn how to use a plugin. This is how you can invoke Tauri commands defined in Rust. But this is not very elegant. Users will need to find the command name from the documentation, which may be outdated. I always add the API flag when generating the plugin boilerplate. It comes with a npm package. In webview source index.ts file, you define and export a function. Then run npm run build to build it into JavaScript. In package.json, this webview distribution folder will be the entry point to the JavaScript package. Regular JavaScript framework generates their production build into a distribution folder and git ignore them. But Tauri plugin by default doesn't git ignore the distribution folder, so that instead of installing from npm registry, people could also install with GitHub URL directly. One thing to notice is that Rust crate name and JavaScript API package name are different by default. The npm package has API in its name to indicate that it's an API, but not the actual plugin. Also, when creating the boilerplate, we set the name to clipboard, not Tauri-plugin-clipboard, because Tauri API automatically prepend Tauri-plugin to the package name. Another reason I recommend including an API package for any plugin is type. Let me use the SysteminFo plugin as an example. It's very simple. It's like a bridge between JavaScript and Rust libraries. For example, with the SysteminFo plugin, you can get CPU information by calling the invoke function and get the data directly without calling a single line of Rust code. But the problem is, the invoke function has a return type of promise unknown. You don't really know what data you obtained from the command, and there is no intelligence for autocomplete. You have to define the types manually. This is tedious and doesn't take advantage of TypeScripts. It should be the plugin's author's responsibility to provide types to users. I personally always include a TypeScript API package in my plugins. I also like to provide ZOD schemas, which can be used to validate the returned value. In a ZOD schema, you can specify the type for each field, then infer the type from the schema. Users can use the parse method from the schema to validate the returned value. This also helps catching bugs early and save a ton of time. For example, if you made some changes to the Rust code or upstream library is updated and resulting changes in the returned value, ZOD schema could catch the bugs immediately, as the ZOD schema defines what data structure you expect to receive. When the plugin is ready, build the JavaScript package first, then write some sample code to test and demonstrate how to use the plugin. In package.json and cargo.toml file of your example Tauri app, the boilerplate comes with a local dependency link to the plugin's root folder. Now, the plugin is ready. Push your code to GitHub, then users can install the plugins like this using GitHub URL directly. You can optionally include git tag or branch. However, my favorite way is still publishing the packages to npm registry and crates.io. To do that, I like to first make sure the version matches for the current release to avoid confusion. Then logging and publish with npm and cargo. Very straightforward. This is how it looks like when the plugin is published. You can verify on the website. Now users can install the plugin directly with the plugin name. As I have mentioned in the beginning, Awesome Tauri is a good place to find sample code and plugins. You can find more plugins on crates.io by searching for Tauri-plugin. Most plugins should start with this prefix. For example, you can find Tauri's official Clipboard Manager plugin for version 2, which is still in offer. The current way of using Tauri's Clipboard API is through API package and feature flag. At the time this video is made, version 2 is still in offer. If you go to Tauri's beta documentation, you can see that they're switching to use plugins for adding extra functionalities. We can expect more plugins in the future. That's all for this video. In the coming videos, I will make some real projects. Stay tuned.